Okay, it's time for the test. You know the drill. If you can keep some crackers and ginger ale down for 30 minutes without barfing or juicy pooping, you can come out for Thanksgiving dinner, okay? If not, you gotta stay in here, honey. This apartment's too small for anyone with the stomach flu to be mingling. It's our system and it works.
I bet he barfs in 10 minutes. Should we do a pool?
I am not gonna barf again. I'm feeling great. I'm eating. I'm drinking. And see? I'm fine. Oh, it's coming out both ways again. Oh, God. I gotta sit down. No, I gotta stand up.
I'm so sorry, Gene, but no Thanksgiving dinner for you today, baby.
That wasn't me. That was a pigeon that flew in here. He seems very sick. I can come to dinner.
Here we go. Brie and roasted pears.
Oh, I can't eat this. I'm lactose intolerant, Bob. You know a psychic told me that.
Yeah, Dad, you know a psychic said that.
Huh, I guess we could just pick the pears out and eat those. The recipe called for apples, but I use pears.
So bold.
Oh, my God. My ghost, Devin, must have followed me here. He's obsessed with me.
It's not a ghost, Gail. It's Gene.
Girls, go check on him.
You doing okay in there? How's the barf biz?
I think I pooped out the part of my brain that knew everything that was happening on the Kaminsky method.
Whoa, that's most of his brain.
Wait, do I smell warm cheese? Do you guys have Dad's hot brie out there?
No.
Ah, it's bad enough I have to smell the rosemary bread baking in the oven. I can't believe I'm missing the best food day of the year. It's not fair.
Is there anything we can do for you? Do you want us to do a dance? I mean, we could do it and then describe it to you.
Tell me a story. Take my mind off this agony.
What kind of story?
A story about anything other than food.
Wait, no. Make me hate food.
Okay. You want to hate food?
Yeah.
Ho, ho. I'll make food wish it had never been born.
So, it was Thanksgiving Day, 1987.
But inside the chopper of the elite special forces unit led by Gene Dutch Oven Belcher, no one was celebrating.
The melted butter river. Beautiful, but deadly.
What?
I said the melted butter.
I can't hear you. The helicopter's too loud.
What?
Huh?
What?
Never mind.
What?
Welcome to the jungle. Like in the song. Come on, follow me. Let's move. All right, here's the deal. The cabinet minister went across the border on some kind of mission that I'm not going to explain right now, because it really was just to set the plot in motion.
Right.
Anyways, a lot of action in the wheat jungle this time of year. People smuggling wheat to make fresh rosemary bread for Thanksgiving dinner.
Thanksgiving dinner? I never eat it, because I don't thank the world.
It thanks
me
for saving it. Well, if it is an old Dutch oven.
If you smelt it, you know I dealt it. Sorry, I'm so strong.
Sorry, I'm so strong. But even Dutch Oven wasn't ready for what was about to happen. Because waiting for them out there in the wheat trees.
Wait, wheat doesn't actually grow on trees.
Oh my God, Tina, I was just getting to the exciting part.
Plus I'm pretty sure wheat grows on trees.
Correct, Gene. Like I said, waiting for them out there was the most terrifying creature that special effects could make in the year 1987. The Breadator.
So, breadator. It's like predator, but made of bread?
Yes, exactly. And Gene is going to hate bread by the time the story is over.
That helicopter is all messed up!
And the whole crew is gone.
Yeah, maybe they went to go look for snacks.
Or they became snacks.
Mother of Mindy!
That's the cabinet minister and his security detail.
Are they dead?
No, they're breathing, but it looks like they've been turned into human carbs.
Hey! What are you doing on my turf? There must have been a mix-up. Gail, take the weapons.
Okay.
Who are these guys?
Just some local smugglers. Let me do the talking. Look, Linda, we're not here for you. Got a couple of our guys turned into freaky flaky pastries by some kind of psycho. So just let us go so we can find whoever did this.
Wowzers. Those are some creepy croissants.
They got twisted up.
The Predator started firing huge globs of unbaked dough at the squadron, but it could make itself invisible, so they couldn't see the monster as it attacked.
Take cover! I'll load the butt blaster!
Who's firing at us?
Not who, what. Look!
Oh, we got him!
Get down!
No!
Better bread than dead.
Hey, this one can talk. Wounding that thing must have made it less powerful.
Oh, my face! Oh, no!
Ow.
We gotta go after it!
No. We've got too many people turned into bread products already. I need you to go back to the camp on foot and come back here with a chopper and some saran wrap so we can keep our friends from going stale.
What about the monster?
That doughboy is about to step into the oven. The Dutch oven.
Oh, what a cool thing to say.
I know. Now go!
Oh, I look good. I'm just gonna eat one of me. Hey, get back here! Don't eat me, I'm you, stupid.